Hello guys, today we are going to discuss the topic of calendars. Let's see the first question of this. Question number one, today is Monday, after 60 days it will be. So in this type of question, if you see there are 60 days, so you have to convert these days into week. So we divide 60 by 7 because there are 7 days in a week, and we will get the remainder, which is going to left is 4. Okay, because 7 8 is 56, we left with 4 days. So if today is Monday, after 4 days it will be going to be a Friday. Okay, so from Monday if we count 4 days, the answer is going to be B. Let's see our question number 2. It was Sunday on January 1st 2006. What was the day of the week January 1st 2010? So in this question, if we see on 1st January, it is saying it is Sunday. So if we talk about next year in 2007, it is going to be Monday on 1st January. If we talk about 2008, it is going to be leap year, but we are taking January, so it is going to be Tuesday. In 2009, because 2008 was the leap year, so we will take after 2 days, that is Thursday. So 2009 1st January is going to be Thursday. In 2010, it will be going to be a Friday. Okay, so if we see the 1st January of 2010 is going to be a Friday. So if we see in the option D is the correct option. Let's see our next question. Question 3. What was the day of the week on 28th May 2006? So question is asking for 28th May 2006. In this type of question, we have a pattern by which we can solve this question. So we take the last two digits of the year, that is 06, and we divide this digit by 4. And we will add it into this number. So if we divide 6 by 4, okay, we add these two. Now we will take the date. What is the date? That is 28. Then we take the month. Now for month and for year, this table is given. According to this, we are going to take the month and the year number. So if you are talking about May, we have to take number 1. We take number 1. If we talk about year, that is 2006, so according to this table, we will going to take for the year, the number is going to be 2000, that is 06, because from 2000 to 2099 we are going to take number 6. Now we have to add all these numbers. 28 plus 1 plus 1 and 2 sixes, we got 42, and we have to divide this number by 7. If this number is divided by 7, the remainder which we get, we will going to check with this table, that is the number of week. So 42 divided by 7, and we get the remainder 0. So if 0 is given, then according to this table, if we can see that 0 is on Sunday. Okay, so the day is going to be on 28th May 2006 is going to be a Sunday, that is option number C. So option C is the correct option. Let's see our next question, question number 4. Again in this question, what was the day of the week on June 1998? So first we know this table. Again we are going to do the same thing. We take last two digit of the this year, that is 98. Okay, next thing, we are going to divide it by 4. Okay, and the quotient which we get is 24. Okay, then we are going to take the date, that is 17th. Then we are going to take the month. So month is June, so according to this table, we are going to take 4, the number, and for the year, we are talking about from 1990 to 1999, that means the number is going to be 0. Okay, now we are going to add all these numbers. We will get the total sum 143. If we divide it by 7, we will get the remainder. We know that 140 is divided by 7, but 3 is left, so we can say the remainder is going to be 3. Now if we see according to this table, the number 3 is going to be a Wednesday. So if we see in the option C is the correct option. So by this method, you can see or you can solve this type of question very easily. Let's see our last question, question 5. Which is the leap year from the following? So for the leap year, we have to check that whether the year is going to divisible by 4 or not. If the year is divisible by 4, then we can say it is a leap year. And if it is not divisible by 4, then we can say it is an ordinary year. If the year, or if you get any year like 1800, like a century you have gotten, but their last two digits are not divisible by 4, so in this type of question we are going to divide the century with 400. And if the century is divided by 400, then you can say it is going to be a leap year. Okay, otherwise it is an ordinary year. So which is the leap year from the following? So if we see, first option, that is 2005, is not divisible by 4. 7 is also not divisible by 4, but 2008 is divisible by 4. So we can say that 2008 is the leap year. So option C is the correct option. Thank you for watching the video. Stay tuned for more videos and subscribe our channel.